questions for whoever's ready. Go ahead, Brian.
Matt, what was the final play there? Were you trying to get it to Isaac, or trying to get Isaac to kick it back out to the corner?
No, we were trying to get it to Isaac. Just something basic we run, just to isolate him. We normally try to go to one of the other guys and throw it to him, but they did a good job denying, so we were able to get it, you know, directly to him, so.
He's obviously improved himself as a free throw shooter pretty much precisely for this moment, so of course it's great.
Yeah, it's, you know, we didn't get to the free throw line much. That's probably the fewest amount of free throws we've shot all year. It was good that he knocked it. It probably helped us that he, even though Matt used his shot about one in, it probably helped us that he missed the second one. So we were trying to get a sub in for him and then get a guy on the ball if he made it. And so we could switch on plays. It's easier for us. But he missed that. But I think in those situations it helps you. But I get worried about him if there's an open court ball screen because he's so big.
Did that sort of sum Dakota up, that play he made beforehand to strip the guy driving the basket?
We had another strip over there in that corner. So Dakota's got really good hands. He's a good defender, does a good job, and I thought he did a good job. We switched a lot today, so he was on a lot of different people. But always try to make good players and good scores. You know, either shoot the same amount of shots as points or obviously more. So Matthew's getting 14 points on 14 shots. It's pretty good.
Did you get any more of an explanation on the replay than what we got?
They just said it hit. I had no clue. I'm so far away from it. But you're in that moment, so you might as well ask. Mm-hmm. If they'll go and look for it.
So did you have to ask for it then? And then they
Yeah, we had to ask for it. They weren't going to it. So, but I was guessing. I had no idea. It's so far away from me. You know, it's at that other end.
Knowing they had a foul to give there, did you set up, I guess, both halves of that?
Well, it just depended. Yeah, we had another play, but we thought they would foul us earlier. Carson was able to get away from him, and then once it got traditional at the hash on the side, where you run your side out of bounds plays, that's why, you know, we were able just to run something that we normally run. But we had something set if they fouled us, like in front of their bench on the side, three quarters, or at half court. It was going to be something different, something very basic, but yeah, we had something there. And that's the risk you run. I don't foul a lot of times. Say you got a foul to give, but now you're in the bonus the next foul. And so if something happens like it did, now they're shooting free throws. I'd rather make them, you know, kind of make it at that point.
You got a pretty big game from Carson, including a couple pretty big shots there at the end. Just how would you kind of assess his play in terms of?
Well, I thought he had a good game. I thought he did a good job pressuring the ball. I thought he did a good job guarding Rockman. He seems like he's had a lot of success against us. I thought he played well on both ends of the court. He made a couple big shots. I thought they had the momentum in the last 4 minutes of the game. And we were answering them. They weren't answering us. I guess it's kind of the way you look at it as a coach. Every time they scored a basket, it seems like whether Vince Edwards hit that three or Carson made those two, we just kind of kept making some plays just to hang in there. And then obviously we got a break. And I don't think it's any different than them beating us in the Big Ten tournament. You know, I thought, you know, we missed a layup. We missed the front end of a 1-1. It gets into overtime and they beat us. There we just, you know, we're able to make a play and it barely hits his fingertip at the end. And so we get the ball. So it's just your luck. It's just lucky. You know, you're just fortunate to get a bounce, and we were able to get a bounce and get a victory.
Can you talk a little bit about defensively switching on the perimeter with Haas?
Yeah.
You know, he really got burned a couple times out there.
Did you see the game here last year?
Yeah.
We weren't going to do that again. So you're going to beat us a different way. You know, it's like, gives Adrian Simpson credit. All right, he almost beat us, but my man didn't beat us, Mo Bogdan, and he destroyed us last year. So I wasn't going to watch that again. I watched that movie. You know, so I got all the respect in the world for him, but Mo Bogdan was a stud, and we were going to let him beat us again.
After seeing it play out, how did Matt Harms kind of changed the game just in terms of matchups?
Well, he
and stuff
can
like
give
that.
Some blocks. You know, he can move his feet. You know, it's hard for Isaac. You know, Isaac was getting upset, you know, every time he, you know, hit those threes. And what we needed to be upset about is not boxing out on free throws. We gave up 6 points. They ended up being 2 3-point plays. And that's what our big guys got to do a better job is. But we didn't want them. They get people on rotations, and he's such a good coach. And they just pinball the ball around. They just do whatever the hell they want. We just didn't want that to happen. We wanted them to go make individual plays versus those guys, you know, catching and shooting. I give them credit, they did. You know, I thought Simpson was fabulous. I thought he had a great game. But we needed to score the ball at the other end. We missed a lot of shots at the rim, and we got to do a better job. We had to score more points, I felt, to beat Michigan.
Do you expect to see that much of Livers and your thoughts on this part?
Well, Livers, you know, his two best games he's played are the last two games, so yeah. And we said we wanted to stay with him. So when he made that three in front of their bench and we didn't stay with him, let him shoot that. That was a breakdown on our part. But making him drive there at the end and make that play, that's, you know, you don't want him just to catch and shoot. But no, we thought since how well he played at Iowa and against Illinois that we would see more of him. I didn't think we would see less of Duncan Robinson, but he liked that matchup. I think they liked that matchup of him guarding Vince Edwards and switching out on some screens. And they did a good job of switching. They did a really good job of bottoming us up on some of our action. He's a good player. We recruited him. He's a really good player.
That's one, Brad.
What did happen to Dakota?
He cut his eye.
Yeah.
He got like a gash right there.
He hit his head on the floor.
Yeah. He'll be all right.
How many black eyes he had now?